With the ability to sequence ancient DNA, we now know that some modern humans got busy with each other, Neanderthals, and at least two other ancient human groups. Which begs the question, who wouldn't our ancestors get freaky with? Hey guys, anatomically modern human Natalia Reagan here for D News. When our ancestors left Africa and trekked into Europe, the Middle East, and Asia, they crossed paths with other ancient human groups like Neanderthals, Denisovans, and at least one other group. Apparently humans weren't so picky about their sexual partners, so they admixed, science for getting down with, these other archaic humans. How do we know? It's all in the genes. Scientists have been able to find DNA of these archaic humans in living populations today. This love story has four characters. First, Neanderthals. These hardy hominids lived in Europe, the Middle East, and Western Asia roughly 400,000 to 40,000 years ago. Because they lived in the harsh cold of Eurasia, far before modern humans left Africa, their biology was adapted to that climate. They had thicker and lighter skin, which helped with vitamin D absorption, a bigger nose designed to warm cold air, and a stockier build to retain heat. Trey sexy, no? Second character in this love story? Well, in 2008, a new archaic human lineage was discovered in a Denisova cave in Siberia. Scientists found a finger bone with viable DNA and were able to sequence the genome. It turns out it belonged to a young adult female who lived roughly 40,000 years ago, and these new archaic humans were dubbed the Denisovans. Researchers have been able to find traces of Denisovan DNA in populations as far as Southeast Asia, stretching to Australia. This indicates that Denisovans and their descendants may have had a greater geographic area than previously thought. The third character in this love story? Well, that's technically anatomically modern humans, us. There is a fourth mystery guest, but we'll come back to them later. So in 2003, we sequenced the human genome. In 2010, we sequenced the Neanderthal and the Denisovan genome about the same time. Now that we've done all that, we can compare all this DNA. And the results were shockingly sexy. Scientists found Neanderthal DNA, Denisovan DNA, and that mystery group's DNA in current living populations. This is how we know that many people of Eurasian descent have a small percentage of Neanderthal DNA in their genome, like our very own Trace.
Natalia, do these genes make me look like a Neanderthal?
Give or take Trace percent.
All right.
But what were the potential benefits of mixing with Neanderthals and Denisovans? Besides producing Trace, of course. I mean, really. When humans mated with these ancient groups, scientists argue that they picked up genes that improved their immune system and helped them adapt to a new environment. Researchers found that those of European and Asian ancestry had higher abundance of human leukocyte antigen genes, or HLAs. HLA is a protein that helps regulate our immune system. This is an example of hybrid vigor, or the tendency of a crossbred individual to show qualities superior to those of both parents. And remember that fourth mystery group we danced around? Well, scientists have found another population of archaic humans that we got friendly with when we migrated to Asia and down into Australasia. This unknown DNA has been found in populations of South Asians, Southeast Asians, and Australasians, including the population of the Andaman Islands. Roughly 2 to 3% of this unknown DNA has been found in individuals in the region. Researchers think that this new possible ancestor could help explain the shorter stature of people in those areas. These new data also support that there was only one wave of migration out of Africa into Asia rather than two waves, as is also hypothesized. DNA is truly fascinating. Not only is it the building blocks of an organism, it can tell you the story of a species' journey through time and space. Oh, and who they boned. And mixing with Neanderthals may have been good for our health, but research shows they were far smarter and artistic than previously given credit for. Check it out! What about you? Would you get down with a Neanderthal, a Denisovan, an unknown human ancestor? Come on, be honest. Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to like and subscribe for D News every day of the week.